Everyone remembers Gudramadweep was the place of kirtan. Now we're in Madhyamadweep.
Hare Krishna.
And the process of devotional service here, smaranam, with proper hearing and chanting, then remembrance is very easy. Remembrance will come naturally. So this place called Madhyamadweep. There are two descriptions of the Navadvipa Parikram, two sources of evidence. One comes from Bhakti Ratnakara. In Bhakti Ratnakara, you have Ishan Thakur taking Srinivasacharya on Parikrama. Ishan was the servant of Sachimata. In the home of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Ishan was the servant. And after Lord Chaitanya took sannyas, Ishan remained and served Sachimata. So in Bhakti Ratnakar describe how Ishan Thakur took Srinivasacharya on this Navadvipam Parikram. Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, in his Navadvipam Mahatmya, he describes how Lord Nityananda brought Jiva Goswami on this Parikram. So we have these two different descriptions. This particular island of Madhyamadweep, there's description of how this place got the name Madhyamadweep. Madhyam means the middle of the day. And it describes how the Sapta Rishis, the seven Rishis, they came to visit Lord Brahma, and they saw that Lord Brahma was chanting the names of Gauranga, and he was in great ecstasy. So they asked Lord Brahma how they could develop that Gauranga praise. So he told them, you should go to Navadvipa Dham. In Navadvipa Dham, it's very easy to develop Gaura praise. And with Gaura praise, then you become qualified to enter into Braja Dham and worship Radha and Krishna. So the Saptarishis, they all came down to Navadvipa Dham, and they were residing here in this place, and they were worshipping Lord Gauranga, chanting the holy name, and they were praying, they were fasting, they were doing great austerities, and calling out the name of the Lord in great love. And finally, Lord Gauranga appeared to them. And the time in which he appeared was the middle of the day. So this is how this island became known as Madhyamadweep, referring to the period of the day in which Lord Chaitanya, Lord Gauranga, appeared to the Saptarishis in this place, in the Satya Yuga. So this temple here, this is Hamsa-Vahana. Janani Bas Prabhu, invite the temple. Anyway, Janani Bas Prabhu can tell us a lot about the local history of this deity, very interesting deity. Of course, the deity is Lord Shiva riding on the back of Lord Brahma's carrier, the swan, Hamsa. Lord Brahma usually rides on the swan. So it is narrated that one time Lord Shiva was coming to hear Gaura Katha. Sutta Goswami was reciting Gaura Bhagwat in Naimisharanya, which is not far away from here. We'll be visiting Naimisharanya next from here. And Lord Shiva was coming to Naimisharanya to hear Gaura Bhagwat from Sutta Goswami. But he is coming on the back of Nanda. Nanda's a bull. I mean, you ride on the back of the bull, it doesn't go very fast. It's a bit slow. And Lord Shiva was very eager to hear. Right? Eagerness, the qualification for hearing. Utsahan. Right? We have to have that enthusiasm, very important qualification. Rupa Goswami said, utsahan nishchaya dharya, right? Enthusiasm, patience, determination, very important in every endeavor, and in, especially in the process of devotional service. Utsahan is very important. If you're patient, you can be too patient. You can wait too long. No, oh, let's be patient, Prabhu, just be patient. In the future, I'll chant 16 rounds. In the future, I'll follow four principles. Please be patient. Patience, some patience is required, but not too much. Enthusiasm, however, very important. We have a nice example of a very enthusiastic devotee, Maharaj Kulashekar. He was the great devotee of Lord Ramachandra. And he was always filled with this utsahan, this enthusiasm. Because Lord Shiva, he had that enthusiasm. He wanted to hear Gaura Bhagwat. This bull is taking too long. Lord Brahma, give me your swan. Let me go on this swan of yours. Then I will be able to hear the katha. So this enthusiasm is a very important qualification. Maharaj Kulashekar, one of the great awars in the Tamil history, he had great enthusiasm. He would hear the pastimes of Lord Ram, and he would be hearing about Ravan's army and how they were fighting against Lord Ram. And when he would hear, he would say, call our army, let's go, we will all go, we have to go and help Lord Ram. And all, he would get all of his soldiers, everybody, the whole army. He was a king, and he had a whole army at his disposal. He called all his generals, get everyone, we have to go. We have to go to Lanka, we have to help Lord Ram. And they all gathered, they couldn't say, no, come on, stop it. He's the king, they have to follow the order. They had that enthusiasm. And he took his army, they marched all the way to Rameshwaram, and they were there at Kanyakumar, and they were looking across the sea to Lanka. He said, let's go, we have to go to Lanka. And all the soldiers were just looking, and Maharaj Kulashekar, let's go. And he just went right in there, right into the sea. In his enthusiasm, he had that enthusiasm to serve the Lord, to go and fight for Lord Ramachandra. And Lord Ramachandra appeared from the sea and carried him back to the land. So Maharaj Kulashekar is a wonderful example of that enthusiasm. And of course, in our modern time, we have the example of enthusiasm from our founder Acharya, Srila Prabhupada, that he could go to the Western world with a few rupees and a few boxes of books and change the whole world. So that's the kind of enthusiasm. Srila Prabhupada, and Srila Prabhupada also saw that our only qualification, which we had, was some enthusiasm. So he would always, you know, encourage us, you know, to keep up that enthusiastic spirit, to go and preach and distribute as much books and establish temples and do everything. He encouraged us. He told us, when you go for preaching, you should, like hunting, shoot for the rhinoceros. Don't think small time, you know. Go for the rhinoceros. Then if you fail, then nobody will criticize you. But if you go rabbit hunting and you miss the rabbit, everybody will just laugh, you know. Oh, you missed. So Prabhupada said, shoot for the rhinoceros, right? So we're doing that. 90 million temple coming up, temple of Vedic planetarium, like that. You know, we're shooting for the rhinoceros. We have many big programs to distribute Krishna consciousness. We have to have that enthusiasm. And just like Lord Shiva, he had that enthusiasm here. That is the most important qualification. So, Janani Bhas Prabhu, would you like to tell us about Hamsa-Vahana?
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama.
Hamsa-Vahana ki. So here, when you take a darshan, you'll see hopefully the extraordinary deity. It may be covered with flowers and things like that, but anyway, when you go in there, you see the first part is like this, the head, that's the swan's head, and then he has his back. The Lord Shiva is laying on the back of the swan, and he's like taking rest, he's coming down to Yogora Bhagwat, the enchanted, so he's taking, laying down, taking rest, and very swiftly he came on Lord Brahma's swan. So it's a very interesting deity. He used to be under the water. They, about 1 kilometer from here, there's an ashram there. It's a big part of the Alakananda River. Anyway, they would submerge him in under the water, and he'd come out 2 times in the year, I think. And they say because he was so hot, his ecstasy of hearing Gaurakatha, it made him excited. His blood got very hot. So they used to keep him under the water, to cool down for many, many months. And then they would bring him out, and they would bring him to this temple, and they also they do prakrams, they go to Navadvipa to the deity. Even one time they came to ISKCON, he said, please, he can come and visit us in ISKCON. So he came to ISKCON, so we had a big Maharabhishekam, offered a big feast of worship of Lord Hamsa-Vahana. There's yeah, a lot of Shiva devotees here also worship Hamsa-Vahana. Now this, you know this little flower they offer to Shiva, the little bluish one. What's it called? Yeah. Little blue flower they offer to Lord Shiva.
Dhutra.
Dhutra. Dhutra. Right? Dhutra. It grows like every while, and then they garland and things. It's kind of like a little hard kind of flower. When it gets ripe, then it kind of pops open. So it's one of the favorite of Lord Shiva. So the pilgrims, when they come here, they like to offer these little flowers. So during the, especially during the festival times and all this, all the devotees are here, and Lord Shiva's devotees are here, and they come in, and they put these flowers, they offer the flowers. If it pops open when you offer these flowers, it means that the Lord Shiva is accepting your desires, he's going to fulfill all your desires. So, one time they were, the festival was going on, and they were putting flowers, and they were popping off all the time, and everybody's getting their desires fulfilled and benediction sanctioned by Lord Shiva. Then the devotees of ISKCON come here, headed by His Holiness Jayapatakaswami, were having Harinam Samkirtan, and the pujari said, hey, stop. You're so loud, your kirtan, you stop the kirtan. He wants all the Shiva bhaktas here, they want to offer their prayers, and they want to perform their ceremonies. So he stopped, so the kirtan was stopped. And then, like about after 5 or 10 minutes, the pujari said, start the kirtan. And he said, ever since they stopped the kirtan, the flowers are not popping. They're popping all the time, now they're not popping. Time to start the kirtan again. So then they began the kirtan. And then all the flowers again, they started popping open. Jai Hari Nama Sankirtana Ki Jai Hari Nama Sankirtana Ki Jai Jai Gaur Prema Nama Ki Another incident, when the in the ashram, just about a kilometer from here, there's a phenomenon that happens every night. When the sun used to set there, the ashramites were telling me the story, that the light would come, a ray of light would come onto Lord Shiva, who was under the water at that time, every evening at sunset. And they said that
We understand it is Suti Deva, Bhakta Arkadeva Tapadvi, the sun god. When he said, just before he said, he comes and pays his obeisance to Lord Shiva, and we get this a very strong ray of light coming as, Lord, as the sun sets and blesses, or pays his pranams to Lord Shiva. Thank you.
Hare Krishna Krishna Bhutare Srimati Bhakti Vidanta Swami Chidamini Namaste Saraswati Devi Gauravani Pracharini Nirvishesha Sanyavadi Pashtachade Satarini Jaya Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Nirvara Srivastari Gaura Bhaktari
Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare.
Lord Shiva has half moon on his head. It's a very nice pastime how the half moon came to be on his head. First, in the fourth canto of Bhagavatam, when the demigods and the demons were churning the ocean for nectar, Lord Shiva drank the poison that came out from there. And he was feeling dizzy as a result of drinking poison. Because he saved the demons and the demigods from the anxiety of the poison, when they continued the churning, the moon came out. And feeling very pleased with Lord Shiva, he decided to give the moon to Shiva to cool him down. The second, Daksha had many daughters. And Lord Shiva married one. The sun god married the remaining one. And naturally, stop chanting. Those who are chanting Hare Krishna should stop. Anyone who is chanting Hare Krishna should stop. Because you are doing inattentive chanting. You don't hear what you are chanting. You don't hear what is being discussed. So you are cheating yourself. It is inattentive chanting. So don't chant during the class. Chanting in the class, managing in the class is inattentive chanting. So we should try to understand this. So Surya married so many daughters, many wives. He is one, he is not like Krishna who can expand to 16,000 Krishnas and marry 16,000 wives. So he doesn't have the power to do that. So he became attracted to one of the queens, Rohini, and he was not giving attention to the remaining sisters. So they went to Daksha and complained. Our husband has neglected us. He's not taking care of us. He's simply concerned with just one. But all of us are his wife. So please help us and talk to him. So Daksha, he came to Surya and he said, why are you not taking care of my daughters? I will curse you. Daksha is known for being very proud and always puffed up by his position. So he pronounced a curse on Surya. As a result of that, half of his body became sick. So Surya went to Shiva and he said, this is my problem. Can you help me? But Shiva said, yes, no problem. From today onward, stay here with me. So Surya started staying with Shiva. Now the women went back to their father and complained. Before, our husband was with us, but he was not caring for us. Now, he is not even there again. We don't see him again. So please, get our husband back to us. So Daksha went everywhere and he came to Lord Shiva. And he saw that Lord Shiva was keeping his son-in-law. Daksha did not like Lord Shiva right from the beginning. And seeing Lord Shiva keeping his son-in-law, he was very angry. And he said to Lord Shiva, please release my son-in-law, otherwise I will curse you. He didn't ask him peacefully with respect, give my son-in-law back. He just spoke in a very harsh way. Lord Shiva said, I cannot give back your son-in-law. So if you like, you can curse me. I don't care. And Daksha was very furious. He was about to curse Lord Shiva. So Lord Vishnu came. He said, Mahadev, give back his son-in-law. Don't be cursed by him. Lord Shiva said, you, Krishna, you, do you give up your devotees? I cannot give up any person who has taken my shelter. I have no power to give up that person. I would prefer to die than to give up somebody who has taken my shelter. The Sun God has come to my shelter. I cannot give him up. Lord Shiva is one of the Mahadevas. So he's teaching us the duty of a leader. A leader should not give up on the disciples. A leader's duty is to be sure that he is taking care of all those who are under his shelter. Lord Shiva is teaching this principle, which is approved by all the Shastras, as well as Bhishmadev, who is also one of the Mahajans. Bhishmadev was teaching Yudhishthira Maharaj, was training him how to lead. So he told him, a leader should not give up on his dependent. And a faithful servant should not also give up the service to his master. So Lord Shiva said, Lord Vishnu, I cannot give up on Surya who has come to my shelter. I will keep him. Let Daksha go ahead and curse me. So Lord Vishnu, who is very, very, very kind and has devotion for Lord Shiva. He said, Lord Shiva, okay. You see, your son, the Sura is already half sick and half normal. So, divide it into two, give the sick one back to Daksha, let him go, he'll be satisfied. So you keep the healthy one. So Lord Shiva divided Surya into two. The sick one he gave to Daksha. Okay? Bye. And the healthy one, he kept him on his head. So Lord Shiva is having the half moon on his head because of his Surya. Chandra, half moon, Chandra. He's keeping that with him. Lord Shiva is a powerful devotee of Lord Krishna, very, very intimate devotee of Lord Krishna. So, anyone who prays to Lord Shiva, to get a love for Lord Krishna, Lord Shiva would never turn back on the person. We are devotees who are practicing Krishna consciousness. We want to constantly remember Krishna. cannot do that without the mercy of the devotees, the pure devotees of Krishna. Lord Shiva is one of those great devotees who can give us his mercy to remember Lord Krishna. Remembering Krishna means that Krishna is personally with us. That is the power of remembrance. Anything we remember is with us. We are not separate from that. To remember Krishna means that we are presently with Krishna, or Krishna is with us. That is Krishna consciousness. To be conscious of Krishna all the time. Lord Shiva can give us the mercy to attain that position. Therefore, as we have come here, we should not just go and don't look at Lord Shiva. We should actually, in the mind, pray to him. Lord Shiva, you are here to help devotees. Therefore, I have come to offer my hair in the dust of your lotus feet. So, you can show me your causeless mercy by helping me to remember Lord Krishna as a result of my Krishna consciousness. Hare Krishna.
Okay, so we're going to go now to Naimisharanya. We'll have Guru Puja there in Naimisharanya. And then we have to pass Puskar. There's no place, there's no suitable place to have talk at Puskar. But we will speak about Puskar when we get to Panchaveni, where breakfast will be. Okay? So we're going to go now to Naimisharanya.
So now we'll go to see Lord Hamsa-Vahana, that self-manifested Shiva deity, who is manifested in that form that he is laying on the back of the swan of Lord Brahma. So, in the beginning, the swan was in his full form, but when they found in the beginning the deity in Gomati River, so one person, he did not know that he was Hamsa-Vahana Shiva, thinking as a stone, he was using the swan of Lord Brahma to use like to cut something. So while he was cutting some bamboo or something on the head of the swan, so the neck of the swan is broken. So that family is called destroyed by that because they committed that offense. They say broke the deity of Lord Shiva, I mean the career of Lord Brahma. So now you will see the deity, it's a little crowded. So the deity is in that pose that like on his both sides, he has his two hands and he is carrying conchals in his both hands. And underneath the swan, there is a lotus leaf where the swan is sitting. And our Swamis will explain more at Naimisharanya where the pastimes, the narration of Chaitanya Bhagavat was going on. So, and also there are called snakes on the neck of the swan and some unbloomed flowers of lotus. So these are the things you will see there if like it is too crowded now. But still, that is like the appearance the deity is manifested in. So now I'll try to go and show you the deity. Thank you. Chalo.
Shooting. Usman, proper disability.
Hare Krishna, you're blocking the door. Can we have the devotees come out first?
Yes, please move yourself. Hare Krishna.
Chala, chala.
The audience is outside.
Yes.
I request to all of you, kindly pay the audience is outside and donation should be inside. This whole body is Shiva and this is the feet of Lord Shiva and this is the head.
Again?
Yeah, this whole body is swan, and this is Lord Shiva. This is the feet of Lord Shiva, and this is the head of Lord Shiva. Yeah, this complete body is Shiva. I request to all of you, please pay your obeisances outside. Please move yourself. Hare Krishna, please move yourself. Please don't take photographs.
After photographs.
After half an hour, you can take photographs. Kindly pay your obeisances outside. Devotees are coming. It's a request to all of you.
So, this is the call lotus bath. It's not bloomed yet.
Hare Krishna, please.
Lord Shiva's hat. These are his hands. And these are the conchals. Both sides, he's carrying conchals. And you can see here, this is the wings. Like, this is one, the wings of this one. And underneath there is another leaf where this one is sitting on.
Please.
So, as I was saying, the neck was, before it was complete neck of this one, someone used to cut a bamboo on it, so the neck broke down. And that family, like, is destroyed, committing that offense. So this is called self-manifested Shiva deity. They found in Govati River.
Kindly pay your obeisances outside. Hare Krishna, I request to all of you, kindly pay your obeisances outside.